of us is born with a box of matches inside us. But we can't strike them all by ourselves. We need oxygen and a candle to help. In this case, the oxygen, for example, would come from the breath of the person you love. The candle would be any kind of food, music, caress, word, or sound that engenders the explosion that lights one of the matches. For a moment, we are dazzled by an intense emotion. A pleasant warmth grows within us, fading slowly as time goes by, until a new explosion comes along to revive it. Each person has to discover what will set off those explosions in order to live, since the combustion that occurs when one of them is ignited is what nourishes the soul.
Good morning. Now it's time for Time for All Ages, so I'd like all the young and the young at heart to join me up here today. My name is Stephanie Hoffman, if I haven't met you before. Jen Bosser is also taking this week off. And here we have our Wonder Box for today. Would you like to open the Wonder Box, little Miss Lily? And what do we have in the Wonder Box?
Band-Aids.
Band-Aids! Band-Aids. What can Band-Aids do for us? Well, I've heard that somebody over here might be injured. Does anybody have any injuries?
I am suffering from serious internal bleeding.
That sounds very dangerous. Does anybody else over here have any injuries?
I broke my nose.
Sorry. Here, let me see what I have for you in this Wonder Box. Oh, here. Here's a Band-Aid. Anybody else? Can I help anybody else over here?
I got a broken heart.
Oh, a broken heart. Well, I'm sure a Band-Aid will fix it. And I've heard somebody over here may have a little boo-boo on their finger. A Band-Aid will fix that too. Is that right? No boo-boo, it won't fix. Well, do you think that the Band-Aids will fix everything? What do you notice about these Band-Aids? Are they bigger and littler to help all the problems? Mr., I'm suffering from internal bleeding. Do you think this will help you?
No.
No?
No.
Nope.
Band-Aids fix everything.
Oh, Band-Aids do fix everything, is that right?
No.
No. Especially little Band-Aids and big Band-Aids. We need all sorts of help. So maybe if we could look at the picture that we have. Perfect. Thank you. Oh, perfect. Miss Holly's helping her broken heart. So you can see from these, we have three pictures up here, and if you can't see, you can move up front so you can see in the bigger screen. We have equality and equity. So what do you notice about the first boxes? The first picture on the left. Everybody has the same size box. Everybody gets the same Band-Aid for their problems. Is that fair?
No.
Does that help?
No.
Well, does it help anybody? I hear some murmurings. Does it help anybody? Did the first section of boxes help anybody?
The first guy in the blue and then the girl guy person in the red.
That's right. The person, the medium-sized kid can see over the fence. But what about the second set of pictures, where it looks like everybody can finally see over the fence? Is that fair? Is that equitable?
Yeah.
All right, Emmy, you look.
Does that look fair?
Looks fair.
Looks fair. Well, what about the third section? We just moved the fence completely. We removed the fence. We removed the barrier so that everybody could see.
Mm-hmm. Fairer.
Fairer.
That looks fairer. Now everybody can see. Even the small little kid, he doesn't even need a box anymore. So can you promise that you're going to look for the barriers in the world to make life fair for everybody so that we don't even need the boxes in the world? Yeah? What could we do to make the barrier go away? Could we rip down that fence? But then they'd get hit with the ball. Maybe put in a chain link fence so that everybody could see?
Yeah.
Okay, and before we release everybody to our classes, we have a short presentation from MOVE.
MOVE is a social justice and action group for youth, born right here at UUCFM. Its extended name, Making Our Voices Effective, is exactly what we intend to do. Taking our social justice issues are relevant to youth, we will do our part to love, grow, and serve in the greater community. We aim to work with local organizations to become educated on social justice issues so we will have the tools to create service in initiatives and actions that really bring about change. Empowered by support from our church community, we grow into leadership and bring the 7 principles out into the world beyond our church doors.
So you may have seen us walking around with our clipboards in hand and asking you to sign a petition. If we haven't talked to you personally yet, let us tell you about the 8th Principle Project. Due to the fast approaching time of the General Assembly, there will not be time to get the proposed 8th Principle on the agenda. However, congregations are encouraged to adopt the proposed 8th Principle, which states, "We, the member congregations of the Unitarian Universalist Association, covenant to affirm and promote journeying towards spiritual wholeness by working to build a diverse, multicultural, beloved community by our actions that accountably dismantle racism and other oppressions in ourselves and our institutions. We are petitioning to add this 8th principle here at UUCFM. Some may think that the other principles cover this, but in a time where we see blatant racism in our society and have even been made aware of white supremacy in our own systems, isn't it time to make a specific promise to ourselves to challenge racism within our own structure? I urge you to sign on this promise to live into and do this work. This is one of those ways that we can make our love real. We'll see you in Hoover Hall. I'll be the one with the clipboard."
Hospital and will soon be entering into hospice care. This is why I know that they would be here joining us today for our white supremacy teach-in, and he wanted us to hold his mother in our hearts and prayers. And special prayers also to their children, Ian and Elise, who are probably needing our love and support as well. Will you join me in this spirit of prayer or reflection? Spirit of life and love, dear God, let us humble ourselves today. Before the work that calls to us, as we try to be good people in this world, to take a moment in this precious hour, to carve out time to feel the presence of love moving in and through us, and to submit ourselves humbly to the work that the Spirit of Love calls us to do. May we understand that each individual in this room may be called to do this work differently, and that yet we as a collective have the power as an organization to organize ourselves and to teach ourselves and to disrupt white supremacy within these walls and outside of this community. Oh, Spirit of love and joy, even as this time together may result in discomfort, let it be a holy unrest, an unrest which leads us and transforms us and brings us to new growth, to new life, as a congregation and as a liberal religious presence in this community. And whatever discomfort may come across our consciousness and in our hearts and minds, that this fierce unrest leads us into a place of celebration and joy, lifting up the veil and breaking away the illusions that we are separate from one another. Instead, as a web of interconnected souls and lives, we find ourselves showing up for one another in ways we did not know were needed or possible. And so may we move with the spirit of joy, humility, and curiosity into a new way together. Blessed be. Amen. Whether you're here for the first time or the thousandth, I invite you to come forward or to the sides to offer a stone of intention. It could be a way of honoring a joy, a sorrow, or a milestone in your life. Or it could be a way of honoring a certain unrest in you as a way of naming a new intention to live into in the coming days, weeks, or years ahead. Whatever it is my wish that as you offer that, it brings you peace and also a blessed dose of discomfort.